Wow, that's Serena Williams, semifinals U.S. Open over the weekend. Didn't like a call, ended up losing the match. She goes off on that judge, to paraphrase. She threatened basically to shove the ball down her blank throat and be glad I'm blank and not. Unbelievable for Serena. You know, we've talked about selfishness. I'm going to say and do whatever I want. Cooper Lawrence, psychologist, does that fit into this one with what we saw from Serena? Is it she? I mean, because she's a role model for so many kids, especially young women out there.
Yeah, so she's not usually like this. Yeah. I mean, this is definitely something that you have to take into account, that it was the pressure of the game, the pressure of the match. I mean, usually a Williams sister wins the U.S. Open, and she wasn't doing too well. So you have to take that into account. I don't think this is any endemic thing in her personality. But in general, I would say celebrities are more narcissistic than ever before. And now they have the ability to let us know exactly what they're thinking as soon as they're thinking it with Facebook and Twitter, because they think what they have to say is very important. And they say things without even thinking.
Okay.
You know, the minute they interviewed Serena after, she was like, ugh, what did I say? Because she's not like that.
Yeah, let's listen to that apology real quick. Do we have that one, Shauna? And it wasn't a very good apology. She's come with a statement that's better. Let's listen to the apology. This is right after the match.
But I think she said I would kill you, and I was like, what? I was like, wait a minute. But then I had misheard. She had never said that. So that was just something. I was like, whoa, because I was like, wait a minute, let's not, because I'm not that way.
Not that way. I mean, let's face it, that was not the time to be parsing words. Did you threaten to kill her or shove a ball down her throat? I don't think it really matters. Mike, it's almost like an athlete or Kanye West as well, and Joe Wilson, who had a bad second apology. It's like they need a coach immediately to say, hey, watch what you say here. Watch how you apologize.
Absolutely, and you need to make sure you're thinking from the perspective of the person of which you've hurt. You know, one of the things that I would tell Serena to say if she were my client is, look, you know, you need to tell the referee simply this: I was very intimidating the way I was walking towards you. The words were very intimidating. Had my racket over my head. You know, I could certainly see how you could see that you might have been harmed, and I totally apologize for that. Please accept it. And quite frankly, I'd really like to get to know who you are instead of just as a judge.
Yeah.
Let's try and start a relationship.
Let me get Serena's apology. This is, again, the better apology than what we just kind of heard there. It's a statement saying, I want to sincerely apologize first to the lineswoman, Kim Clijsters, who was her opponent, the USTA, and mostly tennis fans everywhere for my inappropriate outburst. I need to make it clear to all young people that I handled myself inappropriately, and it's not the way to act. Win or lose, good call or bad call in any sport, in any manner, I like to lead by example. We all learn from experiences, both good and bad, and I will learn and grow from this and be a better person as a result. All right,
let me just say one thing.
In the aftermath. Go ahead,
Mike,
Cooper.
Don't you think we're all becoming so Pollyanna? I mean, she is an athlete, and she's basically there fighting for her life, and no one thought she was going to do anything to this Lions woman. She's never been like this before. She's in a very tense situation. I think we could be a little forgiving with Serena, don't you think?
No, not when you're threatening to F and jam a ball down a judge's throat.
She's not, but we know she's not going to really do
she
it.
Looked,
we know,
well, I mean,
we
yes, she, we do know
John
that, but
McEnroe
you don't lay
got
that
away
out
with
there.
It for, John McEnroe got away with it for years, and nobody made him apologize.
Well, that doesn't make it right for Serena to do that. I mean, I think, again, Serena is a role model, someone who's achieved so much, and for her to do this, it was just so disappointing. So, no, I don't think so.
Give her a break. And here's the difficult part, that she needs to own this and not just say it once in writing. She needs to say it over again and not lose her patience when someone else asks her the question to bring it up again.
Okay.
And many a celebrity loses it when it comes time to say it again.
Yeah, one apology should be enough. Get it right the first time. All right, guys, great conversation. Cooper, Mike, we appreciate it. Coming up.
Thanks.